Okay, so I'm Rocky Hernandez. I'm the founder of Quick Clean. Quick Clean is basically a self-service laundry business. Sa family kasi namin, ever since ang orientation, paglaki, eventually, magbe-business kami lahat. So at a young age, nagustuhan ko talaga is agriculture. No? I really like yung seeing plants grow and bear fruit. Yung nga lang, eventually, I realized na after doing some math, mahirap palang gawing career yung agriculture. So, so naging hobby na lang ang agriculture para sa akin. When I started to study, ang una kong inaral talaga was business, no, yun yung course ko, pero nag-shift ako to economics simply because feeling ko mas mahirap yung economics. After graduating, pasok muna ako sa finance. Doon na-expose ako sa consulting. Unfortunately, dahil siguro upbringing ko, Jesuit upbringing, no, hindi ko kinaya yung consulting kasi hindi aligned yung ibang customers namin sa values ko, and I didn't feel good, no, na parang I had to help them because they're my clients, but at the same time may conflict because I don't believe in their values. Yung unang venture ko was actually into construction business, no, so general construction. I did that for 2 years, 2008 hanggang 2010. Pero I decided na hindi yun ituloy at i-pursue kahit na profitable naman siya, dahil na-realize ko wala akong real competitive advantage dun sa negosyo na yun, and di nagsisit dun sa values ko yung norm ng industry na yung mga construction worker is below minimum wage yung sweldo. And since wala naman akong competitive advantage, hindi ko makita na mababago ko yun. So sinara ko na lang because I did something else. Now during the period na naghahanap ako ng gagawin, nagkataon lang na yung isang college friend ko needed help dun sa trading business niya. Pumasok ako to help. You know, long story short, I ended up staying for the next 10 years. Turns out na maganda pala yung trading business, may natural match, no, with my skills, and nakita ko I can really make a difference dun sa industry. So sa akin, I found yung product na dala namin, which is, you know, Speed Queen from the US. Yung manufacturer is also very accommodating na, you know, nadalin dito sa Philippines yung same warranty standard sa US. So it just so happens na yung Speed Queen brand, natutunan ko, is actually the number one brand in the world used for self-service laundry. So at that time, wala namang self-service dito sa Pilipinas. So sabi ko, hey, why not? Subukan natin. So nagpasok kami ng konti, tapos we tried selling it. Walang bumibili kasi everybody was saying na hindi naman yan bagong technology, no? If it will work in the Philippines, may gumawa na yan many years ago. Na sinasaya nila, you know, labor cost sa Pilipinas, masyadong mura. Why will I spend time doing my own laundry? Papalaundry ko na lang sa iba. Pero ang gagawin ko, nandiyan na yung machines, walang bumibili. So when we opened the store in Valenzuela, and that one turned out well, ayaw pa rin bilhin yung equipment. Kasi sinasaya nila, chamba lang yan. You know, of course, it would work kasi maraming foreign students dyan. Pero it wouldn't work anywhere else. Kaya yung first few stores na inopen namin, salasalabat kung saan-saan namin pinag-open, walang consistency, no? Kasi ang objective is to try to see saan nga ba gagana tong self-service. Pero every time we open a new store, it seems like gumagana naman, rich or poor, di ba? Condo, subdivision, kalsada, kept on working. Sabi ko, uy, mukhang ano pala, mukhang okay talaga to. So kung ayaw nilang bilhin yung equipment, kami nalang magtutuloy-tuloy mag-open. So yun, so ang unang namin naging mga franchises din is yung mga sarili naming contractor, sarili naming suppliers, kasi nakikita nila na parang, uy, bukas ka ng bukas ng branch, ha? Baka pwede rin ako mag-open ng ganyan. Until eventually, became a certain size na sabi ko mukhang gulo na. Kailangan ko siya i-organize. So gumawa na kami ng talagang franchise. So doon na nag-start talaga yung Quick Clean franchise. So since ang laki ng position ng Quick Clean, dahil lahat nakatingin sa Quick Clean, Nasabi ko, meron tayong opportunity na ano, i-establish kung ano yung status ko, ano yung norm. So, ang dami nagre-reklamo sa akin dati noon na parang bakit hindi na lang puro top load, bakit pinipilit namin front load, no, yung gamitin. Eh, tuturuan mo pa yung mga tao. Pero sa akin kasi, inisip ko, kung mag-succeed na ma-establish natin na front load washing machines ang norm, grabe yung laki ng savings sa tubig sa Pilipinas. So, pinilit namin. And then, ganun nga yung nangyari. Lahat ng mga nanggaya sa amin, puro front load washers yung ginamit. So nung naging yun na yung bagong norm, inisip na naman namin, so bakit pa tayo nandito? Magsara na kaya tayo or benta na natin since tapos na, na-achieve na yung goal. So doon naman, sabi ko, actually ang next pwede natin na-goal pwede natin gawin is ano, napaka-utilitarian ng experience sa laundry shop, no? Parang papangit. Ano lang, you just go, use the machine. Ay kung pwede ba at least bago natin iwan tong industry na to, eh gawin naman natin ang norm, eh komportable at maganda naman yung mga laundry shop. Noong mga parang 2014 to 2016, makikita nyo, yan yung year na talagang ginasusan namin at niredesign namin yung mga quick clean na gawin na natin maganda yung design. So ang naging goal namin is after maturuan naman yung committee gumamit ng front load washers, is i-elevate lang yung experience tsaka yung status ko ng laundry shops. So actually, dalawa talaga yung main na customers namin sa Quick Clean, no? So yung unang customer namin are the mga households at tsaka small businesses that, you know, want to do their laundry cheaply and quickly. So hindi talaga kami direct competitor ng mga full-service laundry dahil makita mo ibang-ibang klase na mentality ng tao na nag-i-enjoy gawin yung sarili niyang laundry at medyo OC. Tapos iba naman yung feeling niya, eh, sobrang importante ng oras niya na gusto niyang ibang tao na lang gagawa. Okay, ibang market yan. So nandun lang kami sa market na yung customers na self-service. Right now, honestly, ang aming pinaka-unique value prop compared to other self-service laundromats is two things, no? Yung aming equipment, which is we use primarily Speed Queen machines. So yung commercial machines ng Speed Queen versus commercial machines ng other brands are, you know, a lot faster and a lot more consistent in the wash quality. Pero majority ng Quick Clean stores even use industrial machines like, you know, what you see behind me. Which is, you know, once nakagamit ka ng ganyan, makikita mo talaga worlds apart yung experience and yung quality versus using commercial machines. So ito yung isa sa mga primary differences. Yung second primary difference, makita mo is, you know, like if you look around any Quick Clean store, yung ratio ng open space versus yung machines is really designed towards creating a better experience. So what you would notice when you go to a Quick Clean store, hindi lang maganda yung machines, pero pati yung space is inaral namin, no? Yung we try to make it na comfortable yung customer and convenient and yung flow, hindi kayo nagbabagakaan with other customers. You know, we try to invest in things that make it easier for you, no? So yung tables, hindi siya generic lang na plastic, we try to use yung mga mas magagandang tables. Yung carts, hindi siya basket lang na, you know, plastic. We try to use yung madali mong i-load dun sa carts with wheels, yung mabibigat na laundry. So, mas mabilis, mas madali ka makakapag-fold. So, yung mga ganong small details, I think you would notice is built into the Quick Clean environment. Tapos I would say the last is yung aming employees. You know, we're still working on ano yung perfect balance and perfect training. But I think if you would compare a Quick Clean employee with a standard laundry attendant from other brands, you would see the difference na we invest a lot more and we train yung employees namin a lot more. There's a couple of ways, no, that you can make money from Quick Clean. Yung pinaka low cost at low risk, since napakamura mag-laundry sa amin, actually pwede ka na mag-start mag-collect ng laundry sa community mo and just bring it here, no? Tapos dito nyo gawin yung laundry. So may yung difference ng cost sa inyo na yon. So halimbawa, makakapag-charge ka 25 pesos all the way to 45 pesos per kilo, versus magkano lang ang cost mag-laundry sa Quick Clean, baka less than 15 pesos per kilo. So, without having to invest in, you know, all the equipment and the maintenance and the manpower. So, kayang-kaya. Ngayon, yung second naman, mas may budget ka, you can also consider setting up your own store. Right now, I wouldn't really recommend it for the majority of people kasi because of the pandemic, mas mahirap mag-attract ng customers ngayon. I wouldn't say na walang opportunities dahil, you know, some stores still do okay. Pero compared to before pandemic, sobrang mas mahirap to open a successful laundromat now. Sobrang mas mahirap to attract new customers now. Pero if you have the capital and you have the location, maybe, you know, okay pa din. And then if you have a longer term view of things, maybe now is actually an opportunity to get the good spots, ideal spots na binitawan ng iba. Na sige, hindi ka kikita this year, you're not really looking to make money this year or next year. But in the next 10 years, when the economy recovers, nakaposisyon ka na dun sa magagandang pwesto. And you know, this is a very location-based business, no? So if you get a good location, you do a lot better. So that's another way to look at it. Pero if limited capital mo and you need the cash flow right away, maybe now is not a great time to open your laundry business. So mga interested mag-franchise, you can go to our website, quickclean.com.ph. Tapos may form doon, that's the best way to get in touch with us if you're interested to franchise. Meron naman kaming team that's dedicated to handling mga franchise inquiries. Right now, we have two options. So yung standard option namin pre-pandemic, which is, you know, building your full store, which is a full franchise. But we also now have, until medyo mag-recover talaga yung economy, and we understand na medyo unpredictable yung market. So we created a new franchise package, no, na essentially, you don't need to buy the equipment outright. So you can find the location and test it out, we'll just lease you the machines for the time being. Ngayon, kung proven, you can then choose to buy. At least kung hindi proven, limited yung capital that you invested. So that's a new concept that we created. And also, yung franchise fee namin, we reduced it to just 1/6 of the size for this testing period. Once you decide na, sige, okay pala yung location and I wanna, you know, build it out to be a full store, then we go back to the standard franchise fee, standard package. Kasi ang intention lang naman itong package ito is para dun sa mga gustong mag-feel, at least hindi ka all in agad, no? Pwede kang merong pang-test lang. So we do have that. You can ask our franchise team for more details. Now, if you just want, you have your own concept, you just want equipment, then we can direct you to our partner naman na company who actually sells and distributes the Speed Queen equipment. Definitely, a laundry business is a profitable business. Dito sa laundry business, merong industrial customers, merong residential, tsaka merong mga commercial, no? So, industrial customers, ito yung malakihan, no? Mga 500 room, 1,000 room hotels, ganyan. Yung mga commercial naman, ito yung mga barbershop, yung mga maliliit na bed and breakfast. Yung mga residential naman, ito yung mga condo, yung mga bahay, ganyan. Depende sa iyo kung sino yung gusto mong servisan. Pero ang Quick Clean, nakafocus kami dun sa residential. Laundry business, very, very scalable business. You can start with as little as, you know, the cost of one washing machine. And I think right now, the cheapest household washing machine you can buy is mga 10,000 pesos or 11,000 pesos. So, kung wala ka namang other overhead, wala kang other investments gagawin, you can get started with that. If you're looking to get a commercial machine, you're looking at the range pag second hand, mga 30,000-40,000. Pag brand new, maybe you're looking at mga 60,000-80,000. If you're looking at an industrial machine, nandun ka na siguro sa mga 200,000 to 400,000, depending on the model, the brand. So I would think na big picture, kapitalan mo siguro kung gusto mong testing lang na sa bahay mo lang, have at least 150 to 200,000. Kung gusto mong storefront talaga, Pero own brand, minimal lahat, testing lang. No, siguro you should have at least mga 250 to 450,000 ready. Now, if you're looking to have a self-service store, I think you should be ready with at least mga 1 to 2 million pesos. If you're looking to build something na you plan to operate for the next, you know, all in ka na, you tested it, happy ka, gusto mo yan, baka ang capital mo nang tinitignan is anywhere between mga 3 to 10 million, depending on the equipment, the size, and how durable you want it. A good performing store, pre-pandemic, you can expect to make your money back mga 4 to 6 years. In a full-service store, you can expect to make your money back in mga 1 to 2 years. So, ganun kalaki yung difference. Pero, yung time commitment at saka yung risk na kinikerry mo is also worlds apart. No? So, kung nag-full-service ka, expect na meron kang galit na customer every other day or once a week at the very least na may sasabihin na may nawawala o may nasira. Pero ang kapalit nun, maganda ang ROI mo. Kung ayaw mong handling ganung customers, then I guess the self-service business is a better business dahil very, very, very minimal, very rare na magkakaroon ka ng customer na ma-upset dahil napakadaling i-fulfill yung kanilang expectations. Now, in the self-service business, you have to decide, am I going to use commercial machines or industrial machines? Kung commercial machines ang investment mo, realistically, baka mga 3.5 to 5.5 years, maka-ROI ka na. Kung industrial machines, yun yung medyo mas mahabang 4.5 to 6 years. Yung mga nagde-decide no, na mag-laundry lang sa bahay, meron sila equipment. Well, it depends on how sophisticated. Pero yung mga sumusubok lang, one machine, two machines, I think realistically, you can expect to make mga 10,000 to about 20,000 a month. Beyond that, I think you need to ano na, to expand to a full operation na talaga. Yung una, I guess, is you really have to have a plan B. Kasi we thought before na napaka-stable na namin dahil, you know, over 100 branches, you know, franchise, dami naming franchises, kalat-kalat yan. It's a basic necessity, di ba? It's not something that people will want to suddenly decide not to do. So, in our minds, impossible that 80-90% of our sales will dry up. And so, we were very aggressive in investing in our people, training, dami naming mga programs trying to enhance yung experience. And then, you know, the pandemic hit and you know, we were caught off guard na parang wow, we never expected na there can be something pala that can knock out our entire network overnight. So, you know, so that really caught us off guard and we paid a heavy, heavy, heavy price for that. And so, you know, moving forward, once we get to a point now, we can start to create savings again and we're not living on a parang day-to-day basis. Then, you know, definitely we will create an emergency fund. So that's one big advice. If meron kang kapital na 150,000, halimbawa, mag-iwan ka. Huwag mong ubusin. Because something will happen na unexpected. You know, at the end of the day, as an entrepreneur, gasgas na, pero ganun talaga, you know, the buck stops at you. When we were growing, you know, I kept getting this advice na, you know, we need to professionalize, we need to hire professionals. We did, I tried, and I'm not saying na you shouldn't do that because hindi naman talaga kaya mag-grow na mag-isa. But I think the biggest learning for me is, alam mo, when you hire professionals, they also come from different cultures and backgrounds and ways of doing things. And a lot of them are not entrepreneurs for a reason. So if you expect to hire them and they know exactly what to do, na parang, oh, HR ka, kaya mo lahat ng HR. Or, oh, accountant ka, kaya ikaw na bahala sa lahat ng accounting. I think you're making a big mistake and you will pay for all their mistakes. So, you know, if you hire professionals, you have to trust, but you also have to audit and make sure that, you know, they know what they're doing, that they're doing what they're supposed to be doing. Otherwise, if they make a mistake, they can easily leave and resign and leave you with the problems. Professionalizing is not it's not just hiring a professional with a good background. No, so dapat tutuhan mo din and make sure na before mo siya bibigyan ng talagang maraming flexibility, same page na same page kayo na yung basics and yung essentials, at least that you're comfortable with, are getting done. That's the second. The people that have worked with me the closest know this. Quicklean is a very mission-based entity. No? So, mission ko for success is achieving our mission. And our mission is not a profit mission. And so, I would say na our initial goal of introducing front-load washing machines as a new norm in the Philippines has been very successful. Quicklean is far from where I want to take it, but you know, we've made a lot of progress from where we started. I'm excited. I think now, starting 2022, we can really start to expand and to get to develop one-on-one relationships with our customers and reward you for that loyalty. Number two, I'm really happy then na our work with different brands in the space of parang waste management and yung parang reducing laundry waste is becoming parang greater and greater. So I think together with them, these kinds of partnerships, we can start to address laundry waste management. And hopefully this gets adopted, and since a lot of laundry shops copy what we do, hopefully they also start to copy these new practices, and you know, we get to expand this new concept starting 2022. Our biggest objective pa rin naman until today is really to create that cafe. Parang it doesn't, we don't want to make it a cafe, parang, but we really want to create that positive vibe, no, na when you go to Quicklean, this is your place, and we're willing to make the investments into doing that, and our staff are ready to, you know, make the adjustments necessary to create this. And you know, we try and invest so much in creating this space. So you know, if you know, you're one of our customers, you know, who believe in this mission, you want to participate in, you know, transforming your local community, Quicklean store, we are all ears and very, very, very willing and, you know, looking forward to hearing you. Kung nakapag-laundry lang kayo sa self-service ng iba, you've never tried Quicklean, then I invite you to try. Makikita nyo why there is a difference between, you know, the quality of a Quicklean industrial washing machine versus that of others. The best way to contact us is really through Facebook and through our website. On the website, you will see the individual phone numbers of every branch. And then if you want to talk to anybody from head office, then you just message us through our Facebook page, and definitely that will reach the head office.